you really need motivation to prepare for CAT. Motivation is this mythical creature, and so each of us has a different way of thinking about it. So obviously helps to be compellingly motivated to do anything, and you have a clear reason to do it. It's, you don't drag yourself up, and you have some way of geeing yourself up that in some different, it takes different forms for different people. And so definitely it helps to be motivated, and no doubt about it. And so but there are several layers to this creature called motivation. One is a lot of times motivation is extrinsic, all doing something in order to get to somewhere else. That's not the best case scenario, but it still works. I'm preparing, gritting myself through this run so that I get fitter, so that I can enjoy when I play football. That's all right. I don't in and of itself like running, but I'm powering through this so that I can enjoy the other thing. That's all right. That's not the best. Intrinsic is best, but extrinsic is still fine. I don't think you can find intrinsic motivation for every aspect of what you do. It's tough. So then you put that pressure onto yourself, it becomes creepy. What is crucial about the idea of motivation is, so I'm motivated to crack this exam. I'm motivated to prepare for this exam. Set your overall variables in terms of the journey. I need to have it in me to do all the input things, to prepare, to read, to fall, to practice, to take mocks, all of that. And don't pick them on output metrics. I need to get 98, I need to get this admit, that call. The input variables are more under our control. And therefore, set your motivation targets as input variable. Second thing, I find that the need for motivation sometimes keeps on creeping up. We tell ourselves that I need to be inspired to do this work. I need to, it is just not there. I need somebody to push me, nudge me. Nobody needs to push anybody else. Motivation is a starting step. It's a beautiful quote. Motivation is a starting step. To really see something through, you need to have discipline. And so motivation should set you the stage, and then you get inspired, and then you do 5 other things, 7 other things. But don't have a low bar for needing motivation to do anything, especially because the supply of motivation is through the roof. I can take any of our social media things. There's somebody motivating us to do some crap or the other all the time. And very often I wonder, how are these people so motivated to provide so much motivation for so many who need motivation all the time? They're not getting tired. And so there is so much ambient motivation. And motivation is also one of the motivation videos, motivation pickup tricks are like drug. When you take a hit, sometimes one tablet will work for you. And then slowly it becomes 2, slowly it becomes 3, slowly it becomes 4. The quantity required to get you roused up keeps on increasing. So once in 2 weeks, you see something incidentally that makes you feel nice, get a hit, and then you go, if you get a hit from somewhere, then you need to go and find a way to bank it. And sometimes I love some of the movies, I like some of the TV shows. And then I see that show and then I'm thrilled. I like, love watching sport. And I'm thrilled and I feel like, look, I'm feeling good now. I'm not feeling sleepy. I'm all perked up. Let me go and do something. So it is important to bank those moments. Several times I feel people watching motivational videos, forwarding them, feeling good about it and saying, hey, what a great video. And then carrying on with their day. If that thing really pushed you, nudged you, prodded you, then you should bank it. You can't watch one more of that or something along the playlist. If you are inspired, then it can't be on a playlist. Motivation cannot be something that you hit on demand and keep taking, because then the bar required for motivational talk, pep talk, input, enthusiasm goes higher and higher for us to do smaller and smaller tasks. Motivation is a starting step and it's the cherry on top of the cake. So I need to have some intrinsic idea saying, look, I'm going to throw so much into this preparation. And then I build in the discipline to keep at it over and over again, day after day. The odd day when I watch a football match and the guy is turning it on, playing brilliantly. This is a 22-year-old who's setting the world on fire. And I watch that and say, oh my God, this is fantastic. I'm feeling so good about myself. I go and bank that. It can be the cherry on top of the cake or something that provides the starting point. It cannot be something that we require on a day-to-day basis for every little thing. If it becomes that, then you're not using discipline or relentlessness as a driver sufficiently. Find that instead of continuously seeking motivation. Okay? Interesting idea, interesting topic to talk about. You should probably sit down and say what lifts you and makes you feel nice to do something, not just nice to feel relaxed. And then have that as something that picks you up once in 15 days, once in 3 weeks, not on an everyday basis. You can't listen to one podcast every day for 1 hour. That's 1 hour lost. You simply can't say, I need a high bar, something to inspire me, motivate me to do my regular preparation and become unsustainable. Wonderful, guys. Best wishes. Thank you.